Oh, hi, I'm Megan Murray, and we are here with
Adam Rob.
Okay, so tell us a little about your
I am working on my first SAG feature this fall. It's an Edgar Allan Poe story set in the 20s. I'm endorsed by the state of Oklahoma. Tom Sizemore, Academy Award winner Margaret O'Brien, and deceased actor Rudolph Valentino.
That is good.
Okay, so are you from here?
I'm from Barnesville. It's just north of Tulsa.
Here's a question.
Uh-huh.
What's your most entertaining character you've ever played?
I actually think my most interesting character is one that I just wrote. I wrote a character in a movie that's actually played by an actor here. Over there somewhere right now. In my movie named Victor. And it's a guy with in-and-out characteristics and stuff like that. It's really interesting. I could be here forever talking to you about it. My favorite characters are the ones I write, not the ones I play.
And he gets so mad, he throws the controller, he goes crazy, it's insane.
It's a very good stress relief.
And he takes that energy and he makes great killer movies.
So were you guys in the partnership or something making movies or anything?
I acted for him, so I know him pretty well. Yeah, he's a dictator, a little bit of a dictator. You know. Director, dictator, what's the difference?
But when you deal with Eric, you have to be dictator. And he has to be director.
So, have you made movies?
I actually was also a producer on
it.
Yeah, that's.
I try to make movies.
Yeah, and I noticed that you're kind of tall. Have you been eating a lot of vitamins?
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, okay.
Which is why you're leaning down too.
Oh, okay. Could be that.
I need a taller top hat.
Okay. I got that.
We're going to talk about it.
I'm Megan Murray, and you are?
I'm Chad Henninger.
Okay.
Your best friend.
Right. Okay, so do you have any of those screenplays?
screenplay. I have a feature screenplay. It's in the top five this year. Woohoo! It's called Mirage. Mirage is a purgatory type movie set in the early 80s where nobody can escape back when they arrive there. And if they try to escape, then Sheriff Dave hunts them down and kills them. Well, they can't escape. They have to escape through the park and get their way back to heaven, but they have to burn it. So, okay. That's what it's about.
So, how many other movies
have
you
seen? I have hosted voiceover for the Rolling Ton, so it's a documentary. And then I wrote 1899. That's by Western, so I authored that. And also a couple of shorts going, stuff like that. What's your favorite game?
Oh, I don't know. Between Hungry Hippos or any computer game.
Okay, well, at the current time right now, I really, really love Rock Band on Bleak. So I can play the drums.
Oh,
like,
yeah, I can play the drums too. Yeah. I mean, well, I can't do the guitar.
I cheat and I put it on Expert, but I get rid of the...
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'm just playing.
So caught up in the festivities.
I'm sorry, Donna. I really, really love Rock Band right now. And I get rid of the kick flakes, like, you know, where I can just hit the drum.
Yeah, I just hit the drum too. Yeah.
Okay, I can't believe I just did.
What's your favorite movie?
I was like,
what a count, but it's the one that I watch all the time when I'm just like downtime. Down Periscope. And Harlan Williams is here this weekend. Down Periscope's hilarious. I love it. And it's one of my favorite comedies. Now, do you want to know my favorite love story drama type movie? It's Serendipity. Have you seen Serendipity?
I've heard of that. I don't even think I've ever seen it.
Junkie Sack and all those guys? Love it. Absolutely love it.
Well, you know what I can watch now?
You have to see Serendipity.
Thank you.
You might have to grow up a little bit. You're welcome. Thank you. Appreciate you.
Okay. Stand up as tall as you can. We'll get it. Don't worry.
I'm like, I can squat.
Okay.
I'm Megan Murray, and I'm here with
Janet Mason.
This is the Kids Goo. Hey, okay, so do you have any movies that you featured?
I do. I have Libby Girl Online. It's a short film about 3.5 minutes long about my dog.
Woo! Libby Girl!
And see, everybody else appears to love it. So have you made any other films?
I've made some others. They were all about Libby Girl, but I've been in other films. I have another film playing at this festival called Denver. I play the mayor, and I have a song in that called Midnight.
Cool. So, what's the
film? It is about a horror film, a little action film, and what happens when a small town like Frisco gets into school here? What happens when this creature shows up?
Yeah, I don't remember.
Woo!
Okay, so a little randomness. What's your favorite game?
My favorite what?
Your game.
Favorite game? I don't know if I have a favorite game. Yahtzee.
I've heard about.
I have Yahtzee on my cell phone. I've played on Saturday.
Yeah, so that's a game where, like, if you have the matching card.
These things are the dice. You roll dice.
Oh,
you
get,
you get all the same 5 dice and you have Yahtzee and you can yell really loud.
Okay, so what's the favorite movie that you've been in?
It'll have to be Denizen. Yeah, it was very cool. A lot of special effects and a lot of really great cast and filmed all over the city.
Awesome. Well,
thank you.
But I do take a tape. What am I supposed to say about
that? Okay. I just wanted you to know I was kidding.
Are we rolling?
Yes.
That's
there you go, right there.
Okay, so do you have a film that you entered?
Yes, my film is called The Gypsy. It's a sci-fi thriller. It's about a guy who moves into an apartment and it's haunted by a woman who was a gypsy who was murdered.
So have you made any other ones?
I did a comedy short once before that called Stranded, and that one was about a guy who's trying to get this girl, and he ends up being stuck on the toilet without any toilet paper.
Okay! That's random. Okay, so what's your favorite play? What's your favorite play that you've been?
Favorite play, actually. I just finished doing Hamlet. I was in Hamlet in New York City, and I played Laertes. So I'd have to say that was my favorite because I just finished doing that.
I haven't heard about him yet, but I hope I will.
I'll give you my business card if you look me up. Here you go, let's see. There you go.
That's all right.
You look me up, you can find out any information you want. I'm from New York City.
I'm so excited.
Okay, so randomness.
Okay.
What do you like to do?
Make movies. Make movies, that's what I like to do for fun. I like to make movies and I love to go to the movies and watch movies.
Okay. So, when did you start?
I started making movies about 3 years ago. I worked on a friend's movie and fell in love with it. And that's when I decided I wanted to make movies.
That's cool. I like that.
I'm
trying to make some movies myself.
Oh.
I did. It's really small, but I really hope to get. I kind of want to go into filmmaking alone.
Well, there's no such thing as a small part. Every part's a big part. That's how you got to do
it. And thank you for letting me.
Thank you, Meg. It's been a pleasure. I'll see you inside.
Hi, my name is Maisie Murray. We're here at the Bare Bones International Film Festival in Muskogee, Oklahoma, and I'm interviewing.
All right.
Aki Aleon.
Now, how did you learn about Bare Bones International?
Well, through a very lovely little Muskogean named Patty McCall. She saw my film in Los Angeles, and she said, you've got to bring it to Muskogee.
Yeah.
So I sent it to Muskogee, and I was excited. And now I'm an honorary Okie from Muskogee.
We're very so glad to have you here. And so I was at your speech this morning.
Sorry.
And so we were just, you were talking about all the plays you've been in. What was your favorite? Your favorite character you've ever played?
You know, I think that one of the movies which I starred in was Hanoi Hilton. And it was about the camp commander and about the American flyers who were shot down over North Vietnam. And I'm always playing the bad guy, always. But I played the bad guy with a heart in that film, yeah.
So what's your favorite part of acting?
Well,
there's many people love, you know, method acting and they like real life acting. I mean, do you like the stage? Do you like film better?
Well, I was on stage. I did about 800 performances of a Broadway play. But that's rather grueling and it's tiresome. Now, in the autumn of my life, I would rather do film.
Yeah.
And I love film.
And your film that's here, I Am Somebody, how would you describe it to someone who's never seen it?
Well, it's an Eastern Western, and it deals with the cultural divides in the 1860s with people of color, like the Asians and the blacks and the Latinos. Of course, America was a Christian country at that point.
Right.
So we're dealing with an America which is trying to become a big industrial nation and money and gold and everybody's rushing. And so we deal with greed, we deal with bigotry and religious divides. And today, we still have greed, look at Wall Street,
right?
And the poor people are losing their homes. We still have racial divides because we have black churches being bombed.
Yes.
And we have Jewish synagogues being bombed, you know what I'm saying? And we also have what I consider one of the worst things, and that is we still have a cultural divide. African Americans are making it a little bit. Asians and Latinos and Native Americans, unfortunately,
yeah,
are always left behind. So, and we still have problems today, but we've come a long way, but we still have a long way to go. And
right,
with young people like you, I know that you're gonna make a difference. And that's all my film is about, trying to make a difference. Because
right,
we all are somebody, right?
Right.
You're somebody, and you're gonna do it and tell your story, and it would be different than what we've ever had.
Well, thank you so much. This is an honor to interview you, and it's an honor to have you here in Muskogee. So,
thank you. And anybody that's interested, they can go to Aki Aleon, AKIALEONG. And I'm on Facebook, Google my name, put it on MSN, put it on Google Images, anything.
And
they will find me. So thank you very much for the opportunity. I love Muskogee. I love the Bare Bones Festival. And God bless all of you. Thank you very much. Have a great blessed day.
Bye. I'm Megan Murray, and we are here with
Rob Harris.
Okay, so are you a filmmaker or a producer?
I am a filmmaker and a producer, and an actor primarily. In this festival, I acted in a film called Look Up, and I also helped with the production side of a film called Voyage Control. Attack of the Terrifying Tolls and some fun movies.
Okay, so tell me about the
Terrifying Tulsans. It's a film by Lee Bocacci, who's a director here from Tulsa, filmmaker. And it was originally part of a bigger project that we had that was called Why I Love Tulsa. But it's a fun little kind of science fiction piece. Lee's a very talented filmmaker. He's got another film that's actually up for a nomination called Hatch. Having a chance to kind of work with him has been a lot of fun for me. That's kind of what that one. But basically, that one is about two guys who are longtime best friends, and they like to play spaceship. And they have this cardboard spaceship, and the question is, what's real and what's not? It's a lot of fun.
Cool. So, how did you get into the acting?
I think primarily it was just was kind of that step to take out and just try it. And the first thing I did was a theater audition a couple years ago for a play called Dracula the Musical. And from there, I just kind of got involved in the theater community and ended up getting involved in the film community and found out that this place is one of the best places for actors to get involved. You come out here, you volunteer your time, and you help other people build their dreams, and in turn, yours get built up as well. And that's kind of what this festival is all about. So, I mean, just like coming out and helping you guys, doing interviews and seeing you guys out here again, and I have to make a comment about how much I love your hat.
Let's
do it now.
Probably, as far as a film, favorite character I ever played was in a film that we just did recently that is going to possibly be at Bare Bones or Script to Screen. It's called ZT, and I play a zombie. And that was a lot of fun.
Okay, well,
great acting talent required for that one.
Well, thank you for this interview.
You're welcome. Yeah. It was a blast. Love you guys. Okay.
Selma, Oklahoma. Welcome back to the stage, Miss Megan Murray.
Journey for me, and you know, to be recognized like this is just really a wonderful thing. It's actually like a bit of legitimacy. I've been called a bonehead so many times in my life, and now I really feel that I am. But I want to thank my wife, who's down there taking pictures, for her endless support. She had absolutely no problem with me following around a group of teenage girl dancers for a year, and at least to my knowledge, but we'll check the blog later. And thank you very much to Oscar and Shimon. I really appreciate it. This is great, and thank you. Thank you very much.